does replication proceed in one or in both directions from a point of unwinding from an origin? This slide illustrates the alternatives. In one alternative, DNA is replicated towards a single replication fork, or RF, and in the other alternative, after pulling the two strands apart at the origin of replication, new DNA is synthesized towards two replication forks. Another Scotsman, David Prescott, did the experiment that distinguished between unidirectional and bidirectional replication. Cultures of E. coli were exposed to a low concentration of tritiated thymine for a few seconds, and then to a higher concentration of the radioactive precursor for another few seconds, before the cells were lysed in a dialysis bag. The sum total exposure time was only a fraction of the E. coli generation time. The idea was that DNA synthesized in the first short time period would only be mildly or lightly radioactive, and the DNA synthesized during the second time period would be much more heavily radioactive. The dialysis bag in which the cells were lysed was emptied and then the pieces cut, placed on grids, covered with emulsions, and exposed and developed and then examined in the same manner as Cairns did in his experiment. This slide shows the alternative expectations. For unidirectional replication, lighter silver tracks extend from the origin of replication, the OR on the left here, until the point at which the higher concentration of tritiated thymidine was added to the cultures, after which there would be a much more dense silver track. A schematic showing the whole chromosome is shown at the right. For bidirectional replication, the lighter silver tracks would be flanked by darker ones, since the new and more radioactive DNA would have been synthesized in both directions after the DNA began unwinding at the origin of replication, shown here in the middle of this image. Prescott saw images very like the illustration for bidirectional replication.